Alright, so hello folks. I want to show you guys how to lace a hand drum. I got my frame here, I'm picking the best side. Today I'm using a thin piece of buffalo. Okay, I'm making sure this is pre-drilled, so I have holes here. And this is just one way to do it. So I'm going to use two strings because I want to show you guys a little bit of trick you can do just in case your lace breaks and you want to hide your strings. So we're going to start off with our first this one here. I'm going to bring up the bow here and put that in the middle. Use this string here. So it's a bit of a pattern that you follow. Okay. You're gonna go. So you're gonna have to come film me doing the lacing part, okay? Not just me.
Okay.
Come on up. Okay. So we're gonna follow the pattern here. You're gonna go to the outside hole and come in on the inside. And you're gonna come straight across from it. So because this lace is on this side, I'm gonna go the hole over here. And this is, I'm gonna use that as a guide. Laces come this way and go straight across. So I'm gonna go on the outside hole and I'm gonna come up on the inside. I tighten as I go. So you keep following that pattern all the way. So I'm almost running out of string. I'm gonna be able to go one more before. I... this is what you gotta do. You gotta cut down the middle of this lace. Make a small hole. Okay. Oh, yeah, I got a small hole there. I'm gonna grab this end of the lace here. And I'm gonna do the same here. I'm gonna make a small hole. Can you let the dog out? Take this end here. I'm gonna put it through this hole here. Okay. Pull that to the end. Right here. There you go. If you're ever lacing a drum, this is how you fix your broken string. Okay? There you go. That's strong. Alright, now I can continue lacing, right? Side down a little bit. Bring this side up a little bit. So we'll go by and take the strings in the end again. Anyways. Strings here. It feels pretty tight right now, but I'm sure I can get a little bit more tighter. So, that being said, I'm just going to run along the edges here. I'm going to follow this line. I'm going to tighten it up as I go. Now, a deer hide drum might not want to make it this tight. Because I'm using a buffalo drum, right? I want to make sure that it's good and tight. It's holding. Put a little bit on that. So here's our, that first string here is the one that I started with. I'm gonna use that for my first knot. Okay. There we go. Now this one here, my second knot. Oh. got this all tangled up somehow. Right. Okay. Centerpiece right here. So now with this piece here, I'm gonna pick my three laces and start lacing. I'm gonna make my handle now. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, video is already, guys. My son Joey's recording. Already a little bit more. You make your handle the size of your hand. And I do a little bit of a weave in my drums, and I find that helps when we're toning the drum. Tone's nice. When you get to this part of the weave here, you can go this way. There we go, we're gonna stick it over here. This round part. Because I use thick hide or thick lace. Thinner your lace, the more weaving you gotta do. I'll bring this under. See, I came down this side here, so I'm gonna come up on this side. And I'm hiding that cord. And so here we go. This drum should sound really nice. Hope it does anyways. I just recently gave away, or traded, my other drum. Right, my blue one. So now I'm making a buffalo hide drum. We'll see how long this one lasts before I trade it off or give it away. Might be a keeper. We'll see. Handle's turning out real nice so far. Like the thickness of it. Buffalo hide drum's good for a sweat lodge. Tends to hold up. That's why I'm kind of making it nice and tight. Yeah. Hope that'll make it through there. Okay, so we're on our last part of our... If you didn't have enough lace for your handle, you could use this piece right here. Because I have enough lace for my handle, I'm going to leave this piece in. Okay. So I had a little bit of a knot there. This comes this way. I'm just gonna take this piece and I'll put it in there. Pull it tight. Last part of the handle. Looks like it's bolt center. And this piece right here, I'm just gonna get rid of it. Last piece here. It's got a little knot here. Okay. Here we are. It's the last part of the string. Okay. So this part here, I'm just gonna tighten up all of these like this. Okay. Dries even. Okay. I'm just going to circle around the last string here like this. Okay. This is called a fisherman's knot. So if anybody's ever went fishing before, this is the knot that you use to tie your hook. Okay. And it works really well for drums. For those of you that like to berth your drum, there's your umbilical cord. And now what I like to do is I put like these little flaps on the sides. So I take the string, more breathable, I tie it around the drum, and I tie it. Oops. Oh, hoping not to show you guys what it looked like. Anyways, here we go again. Oh, that's a nice job. You tie that string, you just want to bring it to your edges here. Your edges are nice and dry tight around the drum. Buffalo High, dive drum. All right, guys. Later.